Hi guys. So I thought I'd pop on, have a wee chat and show you what I've been up to and stuff like that. Sorry about the poor lighting guys, but I'm using a lamp because my light's blue again. But anyway, I'm not going to go on about that because it's just a nightmare. But you're never going to guess what happened last night. For those that are long time subbies of mine, you'll laugh at this. For those that know so, you'd probably be like, right, okay. But those that are long term subbies, you'll be like, oh my god, no again. So, my new meds, I've got to eat with them. Because if I don't eat with them, it could cause side effects. And supposedly if you eat with them, it stops the chance, it lowers the chance of getting side effects. So I was eating some crunchy nut cornflakes last night, and bit into this hard bit, and I thought, you know, sometimes you can get like in cornflakes or crunchy, sometimes cereal, there will be a really hard flake. So I've crunched it thinking, well, it's just a, you know, and swallowed. Only to, when I'd finished eating, I went like, with my tongue, side of my cheek, you know. Tastes like, you know what it's like, you try to get the food out or whatever. So I went and discovered I've got a big hole in my tooth and it's sharp. Yeah, my tooth broke and I crunched it and swallowed it. Yeah, so now I've got a big hole, or a couple of holes actually, because I think that one's been broke before. And to be honest with you guys, it's the only tooth I've got left. Like, no, I've actually got one or two here. But it's a tooth that I chew bit all the time. This side has got top, lots of top teeth, but no bottom. So I'm gonna need to go and get this one pulled, because I ain't getting root canal treatment again. And talking about root canal treatment, where I got the root canal treatment, it's gone black. So I don't know if that's going to need pulled as well. I've not really had any toothache though for it, but it's, the tooth's dead, so I wouldn't really. But it's, I don't know if that's going to need pulled. And I wasn't due to go back to the dentist till, I think it was March. But I'm going to need to go again, and I'm going to need to get this one pulled because it's broke and it's sharp. It's actually really sharp. So I done that last night, and I realised what I'd done. I'm like panicking, thinking, oh my god, I just swallowed a tooth or half a tooth. I'm like, will it damage my insides? Oh my god, what's going to happen? So that was me in a panic state, and I'm like, what the heck have I done? Am I going to damage, you know, because you don't know what's sharp. So I'm like, what am I going to do? What am I going to do? So I was like, you know what, leave it the now. I'm no sore or anything. I'll leave it the now and hopefully it'll pass. You know what I'm talking about. I don't want to get into details, but you know what I'm talking about. So I'm hoping it did. I did go this morning, but I didn't look at it or anything, you know, because it's like, that's just gross. So I don't know if it did or it didn't. But my stomach at my side is a bit sore, so I don't know. I'm hoping that it's no that, and it's just, you know, my dinner I've ate too much or something. I'm hoping. But anyway, sorry if that grossed anybody out. But it's natural. So it's not natural to swallow my tooth though, but yeah. But anyway, enough of that subject. I just wanted to come on and share that with you. But my brother, we're going shopping tomorrow. Didn't go today. So So we've got to go tomorrow. My brother's got an appointment with the dentist really, really early. So I was like, right, okay, well, we'll just do the shopping tomorrow then. And that way, when you're in a dentist, I can book an appointment for this. So we'll need to wait and see what happens, guys. But I'm like, oh my god, not again. At this rate, I'm not going to have any teeth left. Seriously. And for some reason, the lighting's making my teeth look pure yellow. But my teeth are nearly yellow, guys. I don't know why it's doing that. But my teeth are nearly really yellow because I've just actually brushed them and stuff. So I don't know why it's showing it as yellow. But anyway, so I've been trying to sort out the bedroom. Most of you know I've done a video showing my living room tidied. I've done the kitchen and I've done the bathroom and I've done the hall as well, but I don't think you'd want to see that, to be honest with you. You probably don't want to see the living room either, but you know, I did it. And I was doing it like a room a day, so I managed to get it done. I've just tidied up the kitchen though. I've not actually looked in the cupboards yet and pulled any stuff out the cupboards yet. Because I don't really need to be honest with you just yet. But I have tidied like worktops and tidied the floor and all that kind of stuff. So, yeah. The hallway's been tidied and the bathroom's been tidied. So it's just the bedroom. And the bedroom's the biggest job because I've got everything in there, all my art stuff, all my clothes, and you know, everything's basically in the bedroom. So I need to organise it more. Oh no, I just ripped it. I didn't mean to do that. But anyway, I'll fix it. So I've been trying to organise. I've got stuff in bags and, you know, everything and everywhere. So I was sitting last night. I pulled a few bags through to the living room. I went out for a walk. I went to the library actually because I wanted to go and get a hardback book. Because I wanted to do a alot book and you know, make it into like a journal. I was reading a book, it's called Altered Books Workshop, and it shows you, I would have showed you it, but I don't want to be done for copyright or anything like that, but it basically tells you how to alter books and how to make them into journals, and it also shows you like how to cut books in the middle and make like a, you know, like a turn it into a shadow box, and you know, it's quite interesting. It shows you different ways to fold your pages to make it interesting, like make pockets and that. So I really liked it and I enjoyed reading it, and I've kept it on my Kindle just for a while. I joined Kindle Unlimited and I get books, I can take out 10 books at a time and for the month, but I can take out more than that, but you can have 10 out at all at once, at the same time, I mean, and then you just return the books, and then you can get more books, so, yeah, it's quite a good thing. I don't do it every month, but I do it every so often, when I'm in a mood to read. I don't see the point of doing it, like, every month when I'm going to read the books. So, anyway, so I got that, and I got it on Kindle Unlimited, and yeah, it was a good book, it was interesting, so I kept it on my book. I've not returned it yet because I was like, you know what, I want to try it. And it was funny because I was reading that and then I watched Sugar, and Sugar actually done a thrift store journal, and what she did was she went to the thrift store. Whoever watches her will probably know, and I know a lot of you probably do watch her. If you don't watch her, I really recommend just watch her. She's really, really good. And especially if you like watching long videos as well, because she does long videos and she's chatty. So yeah, it's my dream. I love watching long videos and I love chatty people. So, and plus she does what I do and she enjoys doing what I do, and it's junk journals and, you know, so anyway. She done a book, and she turned a normal book into a journal. So I was reading that book at the time, and I was watching her, and I thought, you know what, I'm going to go up to the library and see if I can get a book. But the book I got, I've actually had to like paint all the cover, and I just kept this this here, because I like to picture. So I kept this little picture here. But I had to sand it all and all that kind of stuff. And paint it black because... it's called Dead Earnest. And it was plastered all over the cover, all down the side and all around the back. And I'm like, I don't really want a book that's, you know, it's like dead all over it. And obviously throughout the book it's going to be talking about somebody that died. But that's easily sorted because I can easily cover that up with scrapbook PG, you know, scrapbook paper, embellishments and all that kind of stuff, and paint it and all that. So I can easily hide it. But I was like, I don't want it all over the cover. But I liked that, that. So yeah, I like that. So I will probably start ripping out some pages. You know. What else? I got this box here. Try not to show the names too much because, like, oh, I'll try not to show the names and then I'll show the name. But anyway, I got this for my Christmas and it's quite a good box. And I thought this is kind of cool for a spine, so I'm going to use this to make a junk journal. And I'll try and do that on camera so you can see how I do. Like, I'm not a professional, like, I'm still learning a lot, but I thought I would maybe do that on camera. And obviously the rest of the box will get painted or whatever, but I like that, the bit for the spine, that would be cool. So that's what I've done. What else? I was sitting in my brother's house the other day and I was flicking through, another book that I got, I think it was Inspiring Quotes or something like that, I can't remember the actual name of it. Hang on a second, I'll get my Kindle if I can find my Kindle, that is. Alright, I can't find my Kindle, I don't love them yet. But anyway, I'm not sure where I put it, but it'll be there somewhere. And you're probably going, thought you cleaned it, looks a mess down there. Yes, this is actually... it's not really a mess, guys, because it's actually, I'll just show you these. It's all in one tub. And that is all the stuff that I've been sorting through. So I'll show you that as well. But anyway, I was looking through this book and there was a picture of like an armchair. And I thought, you know what, I want to kind of try and draw that. Or similar to it anyway. I wish I knew where the Kindle was so I could actually show you the picture of where I got inspired from. Hang on 2 seconds, guys, I'm just... where is it? 2 seconds, guys, I'm still here, I'm just trying to find it so I can show you. Hang on 2 seconds, guys. I know you're probably like, oh my god, she's making us wait. I don't know where that is, guys. Sorry. I thought it was handy, but I'm not sure where to put it. Sorry. I don't know where I put it, guys. We're in here somewhere. I'll put it down somewhere and I'll just... I got it. It was hiding under my blanket. I'm going to see if I can find this. I don't know why my camera's gone off on there. Inspirational Quotes Illustrated, it's called. Art and Words to Motivate. And I'm trying to see if I can find the... I'm not actually sure where the picture is, to be honest with you. No. even know what all this is, man. This is just... Hang on. Oh, man. Hang on. Go to... So, anyway... I wanted to draw this armchair. I don't know where the picture is, guys, but... It was just... a nice picture, and I like to look at. I'm trying to see if I can find it for yous to show yous. Nope. Oh dear. He's probably like, oh, just shut up and just... I like this one as well, and I'm going to try and draw this. Oh man. I want to see if I can put the brightness down a bit. The battery's actually gone low. Can you see it? I wanted to try and draw that because it looked cute. There. Ooh. Hang on, I'm just trying to. Can you see it? Not that well. There. So I seen that picture and I thought, you know what? I want to try and draw that. Mine's done it. It didn't turn out so good. It did turn out alright. I'm all happy with it, but it didn't turn out like that. Turned out a bit wonkier. Some of yous would have seen it on Facebook. You know, I know a lot of yous have got me on Facebook, but some of yous would have seen it on Facebook. But mine's, this is my chair. It's not too bad, right? It's a bit wonky, but it's not too bad. So anyway, that's my chair. So I drew that, and I was quite happy with it. Like, my brother, I showed my sister-in-law, and she's like, oh, aye. And I was like, oh, he's pure wonky in it, isn't it? I was like, I'm pure rubbish at drawing. She's like, you're better than me. And then I showed my brother, and he's like, oh, you're getting quite good at that. So I need to draw more, though, because I'm not... Oh, sweet. Full of sugar. I know I shouldn't be drinking it, but yous have all stopped me from drinking energy drinks, so I need to drink something fruit juicy. So aye, right, it might be full of sugar, but it's nice. And I've still not had energy drinks, and I'm missing them. But I've stopped. Yous have all given me out of trouble, so I've stopped. So anyway, I drew that. And then, as I say, I've been sorting through my stuff. So I have this box here. But when I went out walking, when I went to the library, I went into the shop, and they've got tons of these, and they just give them to me because they're going to throw them out anyway. So I just asked them for them, and they gave me them. So, yeah. So I got tons of these tubs. So this is all like wee scraps of paper, napkin and stuff like that, right? That's just something I bought today. I just put this tub here together. Just wee like pens and tapes and glues and stuff like that. Oh my. I am really sore today. This is words, and I have still got tons and tons and tons to sort through, guys. This is only a few bags. I have got two cupboards full of bags to go through, but I was just doing it a bit at a time whilst I was like watching TV or whatever, so it gave me something to do whilst I was like watching TV and that. So this is my candy wrappers, tons of them for Christmas and that, so that's them. And I like using them in like my art journals. I like using them for making jelly printed tape. Now I use that as a background on the tape. This is smallish images. I know these ones look pretty big, but there is small ones in there too. Big. this is a long video, guys. You can stop at anything he's like. And if you want, you can stop. And then if he's back, come back. You can come back and watch it for where you left off. Or just don't come back at all, or whatever. But I've got quite a bit to show you, and you know, thought I would just do a long video because I don't know when I'm going to do another video or whatever, because I'm like still in the middle of trying to sort and organise, and I would rather have all that done first before I start like really showing videos of art and stuff like that. So this here is like embellishments and stuff, and I just kind of shoved them all in here, like so they're sequins and like that kind of stuff. There's some blingy stickers in there, there's, you know, just wee bits and bobs embellishment wise. Just try to get this over there. I don't really want to show the names on screen because I'm advertising for them and I don't get paid for that, so I don't want to advertise. This here is a bag of stencils and stamps and stuff like that. Mostly stamps though, but there's some stencils in there as well. But that'll get properly organised. They just kind of get put in there out the road now because, you know, but they will get sorted properly. This here is just painted papers and, you know, just scrap papers and stuff like that. So that's all in there. And then we have larger images. So this is all the kind of larger images I've got. Isn't that cool? Look at that, isn't that beautiful? So I've got lots of these that I cut out from a travel magazine. And then in here we have just junk mail stuff, envelopes. That's from a Paramount Teasers. So yeah, so that's junk mail folder. And then we have die cuts in here and ball caps as well, but those die cuts in there. If we go, and that's it. Oh no. And then we have threads, ribbons, tapes, wools in here. So there you go, guys, that's what I've done so far, sorting wise. In fact, I'm not really finished that, so I've got other stuff there to show you. So I'm doing not too bad. I'm getting there slowly. I'm not taking it slowly, but because sometimes when I try to get it all done too quick, I end up getting overwhelmed, and that's when I want to stop and I don't want to do it anymore. So I'm trying to do it a bit at a time, a day at a time, just slowly working my way through them. And here is my paints, some tapes, there's sprays in here as well. Just, yeah, so there's sprays, paints, you know, there's some sprays, there's just some paints, you know, so I've got, and then I've got some sponges in here, which I need to get more of tomorrow. So yeah, that's my paints and my sprays and stuff like that, so that's in there. And then I need to organise all this again because it's getting messy on that. And then we have a margarine tub, which has like my gelatos, my oil pastels. Oh, there's a paint in here which shouldn't be in here. And crayons, just normal crayons, cheapy crayons. So they're in there. So there, that's about it, I think, guys. So that's everything sorted. And then obviously my drawers that I showed you before, when I was showing the living room tour, they've got papers in them and my journals. So yeah. And then what else have I got to show you? My journal. I haven't really done much on this, guys. I didn't even think I showed you when I done the painted. I know I did like kind of flip throughs and that when I was doing painted papers, but I don't know if I showed you these. So this is the first page of my year 2017, and it was confetti bubbles and bling. And then you seen it on video, and then I added these bits because Gizmo was chewing on Louise's boots. And then the next page for that, I journaled about my birthday, so I stuck on a happy birthday on the pocket. There's some balloons and stuff on the thingy, and there's a birthday cake there, you see it. And then I journaled about my birthday. I showed you that before. And that's the quote. Maybe see it a bit better now, I suppose. So that was the quote page, quote of the year. And then I did a rub on. Me and all that crayon rubbing of the Haribo box, so that I could, so that I could journal about how I went and got the tubs and stuff, and how I've been trying to work and cleaning. This was a little pussycat that I'd done on video the other night when I was doing the painted papers. It's cute. You know what, I could actually make that even cuter, the bigger lantern, but I don't know if it'll work. I could try and add like one of these candy wrappers in here to make it look like an actual window, but I don't know how well it would work because the cat's paws are kind of hanging out the window. So if I was to put this over the top, it maybe wouldn't work. What I should have done really was put that behind the frame first. You know what, it might work. I don't know, I'm turning on, guys, what do you think? Let me know in the comments. I know that I would need to shape it and all that and make it so that it's always like, so it would need to be like up here, so it was just the wee middle bit that was covered and keep his paw outside the window. What do you think? Do you think I should? Let me know in the comments. I'll keep it out here anyway just in case, but let me know in the comments what you think. Do you think I should add the wee blue, you know, to make it look like a window? I think that might actually be quite cute. I don't know, let me know what you think. I showed you what it would look like, so let me know what you think. And then I put like a cola sign in the journal, which I'm humming and hawing about now, because then, oh, do you know what? Yeah, I'm advertising them, but you know, it's showing on my journal. It doesn't mean to say that everybody's got to go out and buy whatever it is I'm showing, right? So that was my, because I drank that the other day. And I've seen, I'll do my die cuts. And then my tag, my ATC, lots and lots of journaling, you see that? I'm sticking with my journaling, guys, I'm doing no too bad. My prescription wrapper from my meds the other day, a painted page that I just put paint on, wasted it. It was paint that I tinned, and then I've done this page for the bubbles, Yeah, I've not done bling or anything on it yet, but my shaker card in there. This was me complaining about a takeaway that I got, and then Allah gave me my full order. This was stuff that I'd eaten that week. Another thingy, and then my gift page today. I thought, you know, I'll show you it in a second. I'll show you, but I just want to tell you what inspired me to do it. So, at first I was doing like an achievement of the day type of thing, and I had them in the pocket and I was writing down what I had achieved that day, you know. Some people might think, oh, it's not really an achievement, cleaning your house isn't an achievement, but to me, when I struggle with it daily to be motivated to do that, it is an achievement for me. Being able to get up out of my bed in the morning is an achievement for me. So yeah, so I wanted to kind of take note of my achievements, and it was when I done my it was like a counselling type thing, but it was for CBT. Oh, I can't remember what it's called now. I'd be lying if I tell you, but it's therapy for depression, basically. And they tell you to write, no, they give you worksheets and you fill out like achievements of the day, basically, and then you've got to write like a, if you want to attain, how much pleasure you got from doing it, and also how much of an achievement it was, like how much of an effort was it for you to do it, you know. So like if it was a big achievement, you would put like a 10 or 7 or whatever, and then if you made you feel happy, then you would put how happy it made you feel. So like sometimes you might not want to get out of bed in the morning, but you might force yourself to do it, but you still don't take much pleasure out of it because you didn't want to do it in the first place. So you'd put like a 3. You might have an argument with somebody and you wouldn't get much pleasure out of that, and it wouldn't be an achievement, you know. So you would put 0 for achievement, and you know, so stuff like that. So that was kind of the lines that I was wanting to go by. So before, it was just a normal white page with the white pocket, and then I was watching Nikki and Eileen's live stream last night. It's Nikki Parr and Eileen McInnes. I was watching their live stream last night, and Nikki was doing, what's it called? Affirmation cards. And I don't even know if that's the right word. Affirmation? I don't know, but anyway. You know, one of the things that you write, I'm strong, I am this, I'm that, right? So I'm probably not saying it right, but so I thought, you know what, I'm gonna get my scrapbox. It's not that one, but I have got one, and I'm gonna play the day and my journal for a wee bit. And I was looking up the affirm, I don't even know what I'm saying. You guys know what I'm talking about, you know, the affirmations. Affirmations? Is it affirmations? I think it's affirmations it's called. And I was looking up stuff because I'm thinking about, she was doing it for a swap, and I was thinking about joining a swap, so I was trying to think of things that I could do for it. So I found this one, I can and I will, and I thought, you know what, that's perfect for me to put in my page for my achievements of the day. And that's what I done. So I looked at the picture and I seen the handwriting, it was in a nice font, and I copied it, no perfectly, but I did copy it as best I can. I'm trying to like show you this. So I done that, and I thought, you know, because my handwriting is really bad, so I kind of wrote it in pencil first and then I went over it in pen, and then I put these scrap bits here. It was just like 2 wee scrap bits here, an index card that I was using for paint, and you know, I was just using it as a clean up thing. So I put them on first, and bear in mind that the rest of the page was white at the time and it looked stupid, so 2 colourful bits on like plain white. So I thought, you know what, I'll get the ink tens out and I'll play with the ink tens. So I coloured in with the ink tens and made it a bit more, blend in a wee bit more. And then whilst I was looking through the scrap box, I found a napkin, scrappy a napkin that was butterfly, so I stuck the butterfly on there. And then I thought, you know what, it needs something else. So then I punched out some stars from the same index card and stuck them down. And then the back was just plain white and it looked stupid. So I was like, you know what, kind of going with the bubbles, bling type thing. So I put on my bubble napkin. And then I had normal, just normal written paper on notepaper with the, I don't even know where I would have done with them actually, they should have been here. I might have put them away. See, that's the thing about tidying, guys, because then you put stuff away and you don't know where you've done them. But anyway, it was just on normal notepaper and it was just basically my achievements, like cleaning the living room, cleaning the kitchen, going for a walk, stuff like that. It was just stuff that I had done. And I thought, you know what, I could do better than that. So I took another sheet of the notepaper and I put my ink in and I started covering the ink, the paper with the ink pens, and to make it colourful like the pocket. And then I sat and wrote out, I wrote at the top, I can and I will, the same as the affirmation. And I just wrote about what I wanted to do, so it was kind of more like a to-do list rather than an achievement list. So I put like clean the living room, clean the kitchen, do the washings, go for more walks, try and eat 3 meals a day, do more journaling, which I'm doing by doing this, make more YouTube videos, make more art, spend more time with family and friends. I spend a lot of time with my brother at the moment, but I want to spend more time with my other brother and also my friends. Whether it just be face-to-face friend, you know, like meeting up face-to-face, or whether it be phone calls or Skyping or something. But, you know, because I'm not really got a lot of friends around me here, or my other friends are quite a bit away. So, practice drawing more often, which I was doing with the chair. Read more books, I think I said that. Watch more YouTube videos and try what I see. Because a lot of time I'll watch you guys and I'll be like, oh, that's so cool. Oh, I want to try that. And then I never try it. So I'm like, and get a cat. Get a cat. And I wrote cat in capital letters because I want a cat. I want a cat. That's you guys. It's just a matter of like, you know, saving up money and that to try and get one. I want a kitten, so like sometimes it can be expensive to buy, you know, and plus then I've got all the care and all that. So I'm kind of going to save up a wee bit, get the house organised, and then do it, you know. And then on the back I wrote, take it a day at a time and do one thing at a time. And I wrote those on, you know, so I wrote that out. So I folded it up so that when I put it in the pocket, that shows, you see, so it kind of tells me, like, take it a day at a time. But I really liked how it turned out, isn't it cute? It's a cute wee page. I'm sorry that I'm kind of gutted I did it off camera, because it would have been cool to show you. And then this, I got this in a junk mail and it was the advertisement for Girl on a Train. It's for audio. And I thought, you know what, I watched that the other week, so I'm going to write about it. So I'm kind of sticking things in my journal, but I'm not exactly writing at the time, but I'm going to know like it's there, so when I look at it I go, alright, I was to write about that, and then I'll write about it, you know. So yeah, like my prescription bag's there, so I'll probably write a bit about my medication. And then that's there, so I'll need to journal about the girl on the train. And then on the back page was another kind of happy birthday thing, because it was part of the first page. So I had put that on there, you see it, happy birthday, and then happy birthday. And then I've showed you before where I wrote about my brother's birthday. So yeah, so I'm actually quite happy because I have done a lot more writing in this journal that I think than I have done art, and then these are just the pages for February, really, you know. So this is stuff for February. So yeah, so that's it, guys. And I know that there's still a lot of pages in January to be done, but I can always go back and just do art in them. It doesn't necessarily need to all be, oh, it's all going to be about what happened in January. I can just go and play in it, you know, do some just normal art journal pages or whatever in it. So yeah, that's about it, guys. I've kept these long enough. I hope you've enjoyed the video and enjoyed seeing what I've been up to, and see that I've not just been sitting about doing nothing and just, you know, sitting about feeling sorry for myself like I usually do. So I have been doing stuff. And as I say, tablets are taking away my system, but I think I'm more motivated because I gave myself that kick up the backside and being like, right, come on, you need to do this, you know. So, and I think you need that with the medication. The medication does help you in certain ways, but it doesn't help you completely. You've still got to give yourself that kick in the butt and say, right, come on, you can do this, you get it done, you know. You're still going to give yourself work on it yourself, as well as, you know, because you still get negative thoughts. You still, you know, it does help in certain ways. It does kind of slow down the negative thoughts, but you still get them. It doesn't cure you completely, you know. It does take a lot of willpower to get yourself going, and a lot of work to work through the depression yourself, you know. And stop yourself with sitting and just feeling sorry for yourself. It does take a lot of effort, you know. It's like any illness, I suppose. But like, if like diabetes, you've got to work on your diet. You get, you know, you've got to do something to help get you better as well. You can't just take a pill and think, oh, that's it, I'm going to feel better now. It doesn't work that way. And then especially like with sleeping, I've got to. I was due to take my tablet 10 minutes ago, so I'll need to take that. But eating wise, I need to go in and force myself to eat now, even though I'm not that hungry. And then I've got to force myself to go to sleep. You know, I've got to try my best. I do struggle getting to sleep, but I've got to try and get to sleep. I've got to, you know. And then when I do get to sleep, I should sleep the whole night through. Because I need to get up early tomorrow for my brother, so I need to set my alarm. But yeah, so it does take a lot of you putting effort in to get yourself better as well. You've got to, you know, and I was letting the depression beat me for a long time, guys, there. I was gearing up, I was starting to gear up on everything. I didn't want to do it, and I was, you know, I was done. I didn't want to fight anymore. And then just, sometimes you've got to just gear, you know. I just woke up and I was like, you know what, I need to do something here. I need to start getting my life in order. I need to get down and get my medication. I need to you know, because the sleeping was driving me, the no sleeping, guys, it was driving me insane. The insomnia was really bad, and you know, there's only so much you can take, and you'd be like, I've got to get help, you know. So that's what I'm doing, and you know, it's hard sometimes doing it, but I've got to do it, you know. Like tonight, I'm really, really tired, but I'm still doing stuff, you know. So anyway, guys, I'm going to love yous and leave yous now, and I'll speak to you soon. I don't know when I'll get another video up, but preferably, you know, hopefully I'll get it up soon. I'll give yous an update on the tooth again. So anyway, so I'll speak to you soon, guys. I love yous all to bits. And I'm gonna, for those that are still watching, I'm gonna actually put a song in the description box, a link to a video of a song in the description box, and it's my message, it's my song to all of yous. It's a dedication to all my internet friends. I love yous all. You know, I found this song today. Some of you might have seen it on my Facebook, I don't know. But I heard the song and I thought, you know what, that's just perfect for all the friends that I've made over the past years. And you know, and I wrote on my Facebook that I thank yous all for the continued support and encouragement that yous have given me over the years, you know, and the continued support and, well, this support and encouragement yous have given me over the years, and the continued support and encouragement yous still give me today. Yous really don't know how much it means to me. It really does mean a lot. Yous have really helped me a lot. Yous don't, honestly, some of yous don't realise how much yous have helped me. And yeah, so anyway guys, I will speak to you soon, and I love yous all to bits. And if yous are still watching, check out the video. Yeah, check out the video, because it's for yous. So, love yous. Mwah.